This video is a guide and we are using new, clean equipment. You must always refer to the instruction book for safe practices and specific details. Hello, this is another instructional video from HARDI. In this video, we'll show you how to set up a HARDI Controller 9600 on a brand new sprayer. The sprayer I'll use is a Navigator and it has a SmartCom electronic control unit. And if you're not too sure what sort of control unit you have, I'll show you later how to identify it. Let's start by turning on the display. The display is brand new and we need to set up the terminal. You need to have the sprayer connected to the tractor. The terminal displays what is happening. The electric control unit, also called ECU, is on the sprayer and controls what is happening. This video has six sections being terminal setup, ISO bus settings, vehicle configuration, implement configuration, universal terminal job, and application job. It can also be used to set up the HC8600. This is for software version 5.0, which is shown here. Language choice is the first window. The setup has choice buttons, grey for changes, blue for forward and back, red for stop, and green for accept. Choose your language and press blue forward arrow. Unit, time, and date is next. Choose unit and press blue forward to proceed. Set time and date. I choose a 24-hour format. Press the green accept when you are finished and blue forward to continue. If you do not have Agfinity, skip it. I have a single display, choose, then press forward. Press new setup and forward. I will add my business name. So I press the green add. I do not use nickname. Press green accept to proceed. The next part is the ISO bus settings. Press setup. Now press the bottom right terminal icon. Console setup is shown. Choose ISO bus settings. This is for the SmartCom ECU, but what ECU do you have? The JobCom ECU is fitted to the Commander and Alpha. It is one grey box measuring 30 by 40 centimetre. The SmartCom ECU is fitted to the Navigator and Mega. There can be more than one. For the Navigator, check the right-hand side. This Navigator has two. The SmartCom name is shown on the label. For SmartCom ECU, enable Universal Terminal, Broadcast Display Speed, Broadcast GPS, Task Controller, ECU Section Delays, ECU Section Lookaheads, and Enable File Server. Press green to accept and proceed. For a JobCom ECU, do the same, but do not enable ECU section lookaheads. Press green accept to proceed, and upper left hand arrow to return. Now press Universal Terminal. Whilst it reads the data from the ECU, you see the bar moving. Now the sprayer data and boom management data has been uploaded. We need to set up the tractor and sprayer configuration. Press setup and you see the configuration setup. To add a configuration, press the green add button. Our task is application. Add a vehicle. I add my tractor. press the grey calculator icon. Enter the distance from the rear axle to the drawbar hitch point. The other values are not relevant, so press the blue forward arrow. Enter the GPS antenna location in respect to the rear axles and center line. Press blue forward and green accept, and blue forward again when finished. Add other tractors if needed. Add the sprayer under implement. Add make. And model. Enter the distance from the drawbar hitch point to the sprayer axle. Press blue forward to proceed. The window shows data taken from the sprayer SmartCom ECU. Press blue forward to proceed. If you have boom management, activate this by pressing the NORAG button. Press blue forward to proceed. The sprayer has no rear hitch, so press forward again. Press green to accept the sprayer configuration and proceed. The setup window now shows the sprayer. Press sprayer and press offsets. This is the implement offsets page. For a non-tracking sprayer, leave implement type as is. For SafeTrack or IntelliTrack, press standard and choose the track option. Press green to accept, press the upper left arrow to return, and again. If you want to spray without GPS features, just press Universal Terminal. The sprayer liquid screen is displayed under the HARDI tab. If you have boom management, the tab is beside it. If you want to spray with GPS features and job registration, press Application. The first time requires a configuration of a vehicle with a sprayer. Press Add in the upper corner. I see my tractor and I press the forward arrow. Select the sprayer and press forward. Choose the primary speed source. For trailed sprayers, choose HARDI and press forward. A configuration name is suggested. It can be changed via the keyboard icon. If OK, press the accept. Configuration setup is shown. You can double check the data. Press vehicle offsets to see the antenna position. Press green to accept. The same goes for speed input. Press automatic swath control. You can choose what the sprayer sections or nozzles should do outside and inside the field. I choose to stop spraying outside the field and minimize the area not sprayed in the field. Press the look ahead settings. This turns the spraying on and off in advance, allowing for the time lag between the signal and the activation. Leave it as it is, and if necessary, adjust after field experience. Press accept and accept again, and make sure boom height is active. Your sprayer and tractor configuration is done. Press forward. You see the management selection window to set up the grower, farm and field. Add grower. I only have one business, Strata Farms. I do have several farms, and this one is called Donaldson's. You can name the fields, I just use numbers. Press accept. Check enable management is active and press forward to proceed. The product selection page is where the product is added. Our product is water. Press add. Choose application product, product type being carrier, and water is default. Press forward and select liters as the unit. Then forward and accept. You see the work screen with the active green field icons at the bottom. Press UT to show the terminal screen. Press field icon to go back to the work screen and press the water tab. This opens the rate control settings. Change the water rates by pressing the spanner icon. I will add my two most used rates. With increments of 10 liter. The container folder shows the tank contents and alarm activation at 10% in tank. The water tab now shows the desired target rate. The four lower gray display item boxes can be set up as you wish. You are now ready to spray. We hope this video has been of help. If you want to see more HARDI instructional videos, please see our YouTube channel.